Now look at the next question here, and this question is from the operating system, and generally the question that is asked from the operating system subject, all these questions are very easy, and this is one of the easiest question that you can encounter in your examination. They are saying, consider the following set of processes and the length of CPU burst given in millisecond. So we have four processes and the CPU time is given in terms of millisecond. Assume that processing being scheduled with round robin scheduling algorithm with a time quantum of 4 millisecond, then the waiting time the process P4 is. So how much the process P4 has to wait. Now let us look at this question. So for this purposes we are going to use two things. The first is your queue, because round robin scheduling uses queue, and second is your Gantt chart. Let us try to draw both of them in here. So assuming that this is the queue, okay, and this is representing your queue, and this is representing your Gantt chart, and this is representing the time zero. Now look at this question, they have not given the arrival time of any process. So we have arrival times are not given. So because the arrival time is not given, so I'm going to assume all the arrival times as zero. And when these processes arrived at the same time, therefore we have to consider these processes on the basis of their process ID. So the process P1 is having the minimum process ID, hence it will be scheduled first, then process P2, then process P3, then process P4, and so on. So in this queue initially we'll be having process P1, then we'll be having process P2, then we'll be having process P3, and then we'll be having process P4. So we'll take one process out of the queue, and then we are going to schedule the first process for the time quantum. So because the time quantum is 4 units, therefore from 0 to 4 the process P1 will be scheduled. So this will become 1, and then we'll again put the process P1 in the queue. Then we'll take the process P2 out, we'll schedule the process P2 from 4 to 8. So this will become 3. So then process P2 will be again scheduled. Then we will take process P3 out of the queue, and this will be scheduled from 8 to 12. So this will become 2. So again process P3 will be in the queue, and then we'll be having process P4. So process P4 will be scheduled from 12 to 16, and this will become 0. So because it is 0, so it will not again come in the queue. Now we will be having process P1 again. Now this process P1, the remaining time is 1 millisecond, so it will be till 17, so it will be 0. Then process P2 will come. So process P2 is having time which is only 3, so process P2 will be here till 20, and then this will become 0, and then process P3 will come, and this process P3 will be scheduled till 12, time 22. Okay, now they are saying, what is the waiting time for process P2 in terms of millisecond? So process P4 in terms of millisecond, so how much the time the process P4 has to wait. Now you can see process P4 got the CPU at the time unit 12. So because it got the CPU time unit 10, but its arrival time is 0. You know what is the waiting time? So waiting time is your first time at which the process arrived, or you can say there's one more way of you can find it out, that is turnaround time minus, you know. So we have turnaround time. So turnaround time is arrival time minus finish time, right? So we do not need the turnaround time. So here we need only the waiting time. So how much the process P4 has to wait. So the process P4 got the CPU at time unit 12, hence the correct answer to this question is 12 only. So this is correct. Okay, I hope this is one of the easiest question that you can encounter. Okay, you should know the basic terminologies, what is the process ID, what is the arrival time, what is the CPU time or burst time, then what is the turnaround time, then what is the waiting time, then what is the finish time or termination time. You should know all these basic terminologies. And you should know how this round robin scheduling algorithm works, then you will be able to solve this question very easily. Fine, now let us look at the next question, which is question number 6.